Welcome back to FFMC Part 2. My name is Monisha, and in this video, we are going to talk about how to apply for an additional FFMC branch, appointment of franchisees, and renewal of FFMC license. First of all, let's have a look on the guidelines for the grant of additional branch. In order to carry out the money changing activities at a place other than the permanent place of business, a written approval shall be sought from RBI. A written application shall be submitted to the regional office of Forex department in whose jurisdiction the registered office of the company is situated. The main focus is that the branches should be scattered and adequate money changing facilities shall be provided in the remote areas of tourist attraction. Now let's discuss about what are the documentation requirement for an additional FFMC license. So the documents consist of latest audited accounts accompanied by the certificate from statutory auditor clearly specifying the position of net owned funds as on date, banker's report in a sealed envelope, a declaration specifying non-pendency of any proceedings with the director of enforcement. The new branch shall not be allowed to a FFMC against whom any DRE or DRI case is pending. Declaration confirming the effectiveness of the proper policy framework on KYC, AML, CMT, etc. Declarations on internal control systems, including internal or external audit. A copy of registration under shop and establishment, rent receipt or any other documentary evidence of the place of the business of additional branch. If you are willing to open foreign exchange counter at international airports, following are the criteria affecting the same. In case of foreign exchange counters in the arrival halls of the international airports, the counter shall be placed after the customer desk, or it may also be placed between the immigration desk or the customer desk. In case of foreign exchange counter in the departure halls of international airports, they shall be placed before the customer desk or the immigration desk, whichever comes first. The main idea is to provide adequate foreign exchange facilities to the foreigners to dispose of any unspent currency. The maximum amount of unspent currency which shall be allowed to carry after the immigration desk is 10,000 rupees in order to meet the miscellaneous expenditures. Such foreign exchange counter shall buy or sell foreign or Indian currency at the usual terms and conditions. Coming to the guidelines for the appointment of franchisees by FFMCs. The FFMCs can enter into the franchisee agreement as per their will to carry out the money changing activities such as conversion of foreign currency notes, coins, traveler checks, etc. The franchisee shall be an entity having a physical place of business and a net owned fund of 10 lakh rupees. The tenure of the franchisee agreement shall be decided by the FFMCs, and the commission and fees payable to the franchisees shall be decided by the mutual agreement between the parties. Features of franchisee agreement. Some of the salient features of the franchisee agreement includes: the name of the franchisers and the exchange rate shall be primarily displayed by the franchisees, and the exchange rate shall be in coordination with the daily exchange rates as charged by authorized dealer category 1 banks, category 2 banks, FFMCs and their branches. The purchased foreign currency shall be surrendered by the franchisee to the franchisor within a period of 7 working days from the date of purchase. The proper records of all transactions shall be maintained by the franchisees. The franchisor shall conduct the on-site inspection of the franchisee at least once in a year. For the purpose of appointment of franchisee, the FFMC shall apply to the regional office of the RBI. The application shall be made in form RMCF and shall be accompanied by a declaration that proper due diligence of the entity has been conducted before entering into the franchisee agreement. The reporting of every new franchisee shall be made to the RBI. on post-facto basis along with the aforesaid declaration. Coming to the renewal of existing FFMC license, the application shall be made in this regard at least 1 month prior to the expiry of the license. Where the application of the renewal is made, the license shall be effective until the day of renewal or until the day of rejection as the case may be. No application for the renewal shall be made after the day of expiry of the license. That's all for today. In the next video, we'll be covering about the operations of FFMCs in India. Till then, do like, share and subscribe. Thank you.